that and making sure that that is addressed in consultation with Territory Families, the NT government agency responsible for that sort of area. But look, we've been working with Tangentyre. We're going to be delivering 1,200 masks. We've delivered them this afternoon, and they're going to be distributing those masks to town camp residents.
So they'll be distributing the masks, but I know that there's been trouble in Darwin getting support from the NT government to house people during the lockdown, or to give them the opportunity to isolate or distance. Is the same sort of reaction happening where you are?
Well, I actually haven't been out of the office today as a result of the lockdown. We've gone straight into organising our response as an essential service in terms of health services. But if there are any issues with homelessness and that not being addressed, Congress will certainly be making some noises about that.
You said in one community that would be vulnerable and affected, 87 of 160 eligible people had been vaccinated. Is this as a direct result of the fear that COVID could be close?
Absolutely. This has happened in the last 2 days. The clinic, the waiting room was packed, and that was because of what was seen on TV, the lockdown in Darwin. I think we've got a situation now where people are seeing that it's real, that we can get COVID here in the Northern Territory. We can get it in communities as close as the Tanami Mine, which is not that far away from us. So I think that, yeah, definitely, with that situation, it's certainly going to increase our vaccination activity, and it'll certainly increase our activity in our respiratory clinic, as well as our COVID hotline.
I wish you all the best. I know it's going to be a difficult 3 days, and no doubt it would probably extend it, which I'm assuming you'd support, right? You'd want this really shut down, given the risk.
Oh, absolutely, Patricia. We were, in fact, meeting, you know, when COVID first hit 18 months ago, we were very much advocating, the first in the country, I think, advocating for closing the borders, and now it's become a, you know, an everyday event. And we were advocating for what we called a test and contain strategy, which basically is a lockdown. So yeah, we're in total support of it.
Yeah. Certainly the Aboriginal communities have been at the forefront of saying close our communities and keep them safe. Donna, good luck. I really hope to get those vaccination rates high in all those communities. Donna Archie is the CEO of the Central Australian Aboriginal Community.